Today we're going to talk about how to install the CB1 Raspberry Pi alternative on the Manta M4P version 2.1. Now there's a couple things you obviously need to know. There's ports right in here where you're going to have to connect this. An antenna is required for this, and it's off camera at the moment, but I'll try and move the cup in so you can see it. That will attach to this side. Now, the other thing that I want to tell you is that whenever you're connecting one of these boards, the antenna side should be on the left side of this. That'll make connecting these much easier for you to do. So this is going to be a little bit quicker than the last time I recorded this because they fixed several things. So let's get started. So the first thing that we need to do is actually understand something about the board. So on the underside of the board, there's going to be two different ports. The port that we're going to load the actual firmware or software, excuse me, the image is going to go right here. And if we need to load the actual firmware, being firmware.bin, we'll do it with one of these cards in this slot. So, I've already loaded the firmware in a previous video, so I'll show you that a little bit later in the other video. But for now, we're going to install this. So you can see that there's connectors underneath. All you have to do is line up the holes, and you should be able to clip it right in. Note that the actual communication for the antenna is closest to this side. So we're going to just clip this in so that we can communicate. And it just clips in like a little cup. So we're all set there. The next thing we need to do is actually image a file. So I've already done some of the prep work here. So I'm going to drop this in here and show you the process, but I've already done it on the other drive. So I'm going to connect this right here. And I'm going to go over to the computer in a moment. So on the actual desktop, as you can see, we're on the BigTreeTech GitHub page. And I have to let you know that BigTreeTech provided me with the CB1 and the Manta M4P. So let's go to repositories over here. Then I'm going to search on CB1. This will bring us to our images, if I can spell one correctly. There we go. And so what you see is the actual hardware they talk about right here. They also talk about issues. So if you come across an issue, it may be solved in here. And they say what those are. So I'm going to go back, then back again. And down here it says latest image. So I'm going to click right here. Now I've already pulled the image down, but to pull it, all you have to do is click right here and it will download. So the next thing you want to do is actually image a file. So I'll show you that now. So here's the Raspberry Pi imager. It's version 1.7.3. So I've already pulled the image right here. So we're all set with that. So I'm going to click on Choose OS, Use Custom, select the image, open, choose the storage device, select that, and then I'm going to click Yes for Write. So this will take a few minutes to actually complete. So I'll pause the video for a moment, and then I'll come back and show you how to do the actual setup now that it's changed the correct way according to the manual. So we'll be right back in a moment. Okay, so it's almost verified, which just occurred. So this will pop. So what you have to do now is remove the actual drive for the SD card. So I'll show you how to do that real quick. So if we go over to the desktop, I'm going to pop this out. Then I'm going to pop it back in. Then I'll go back over to the desktop. I'll open this up, go to my boot folder, and I'll right click and I'll edit in Notepad. So let me bring this over so you can see what I'm doing. So what you're going to do right here is put your router name, and then this is your router password for your Wi-Fi. And I'll do this off screen so you don't see my router name and password. So I'm going to pause it for a second, fill it out, and save it. Okay, I just saved it. So it's in here and it's configured. So what we're going to do is pop it out, place it inside the actual motherboard. So let's go over to the camera on the desktop, pop out the drive. I'm going to then flip this over, and you can see these little lines underneath on the silk screen allow me to align it so I don't have to flip the board over. So that's where it's going to go. Now what I'm going to do is actually I'm going to connect the actual power. I'm using 5 volts, but currently I have the power off on the USB for the computer, but I'll connect that in a second. But I'm also going to connect the screen so you can see what's occurring. So let me plug this in. And I'm not going to be using the screen, but it will be on display. So I'm going to switch screens here so you can see it. And I'm powering it up as we speak. So you're going to see something hopefully right in here in just a moment when it boots. Otherwise, I've done something drastically wrong, but it looks like I got it right so far. And then what we're going to have to do is go over to the desktop again and check out the router settings. But I'm going to give this a moment to boot because we want it to get to the actual boot environment where the screen is displayed. So I'm actually going to pause this for a moment and let it come up, and then I'll show you the next step. Okay, the screen just came up, as you can see right here. So what we're going to have to do is then go over to the desktop, and I blurred out a portion of my router so you can't see it. So this part will not be visible up here, but you will be able to see that there's a couple of IPs. So we're going to do a refresh and see if this changes. And we can see that the new IP is 192.168.1.5. So we're going to copy that. We're going to go over to our web page over here and paste this configuration so we can see if it comes up. So this might take a second. There's going to be an issue where you have to set your MCU. So that means you have to actually TeraTerm or Telnet into the device to find it. We already know the IP address, so I'm going to do that real quick. So I'm going to go over here, bring up TeraTerm. Let me just bring it over to the other screen here. And I'm going to do a new connection. We're going to change this to 192.168.1.5. And the TCP IP port, or the TCP transmission control protocol port, is 22, and SSH is secure shell. You're going to need to set those, so I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to click continue. Then I'm going to say the password, which is BIQU, and that's also the username. So click OK. Now I'd show you how to change the password, but I showed you that in a previous version of this, being the 2.1.2 version of this. So all we're going to do is figure out what the actual setup is. So we're going to click on install, and to find the actual listing of the actual firmware, it's this command right here, which is ls, the dev directory, serial, and then by ID and anything it finds. So I'm just saying it in English rather than what it is in symbols. So I'm going to hit enter, and that's what we need. So I'm going to copy that because that's going to be important. So I'll right click and it just copies. Then I'm going to minimize this, go back over here, and we can see that there's an MCU error. So we're going to click on machine. We already have the actual defined M4P in here. So I'm going to click on it. And you can see that this needs to be replaced. So I'm going to type serial so you can see the difference, colon, space, and paste. So that's the difference between the two. So I'll take that out. I'll click save and restart. Now there will be another issue that comes up. It will take a second, and that's because I am missing on here the actual thermistors, which I now will connect. So you can see the ADC out of range. That means no thermistor. So I'm going to go over to the desk for a second. I'm going to grab two thermistors. Now this is only 5 volts, so I'm just going to plug these in. So that's one thermistor, and here's the second one. And the reason I do this on the desktop is so that you can see what's going on. And that's the actual thermistor that would be either for your hot end or your bed. So let's go back over to the computer. Let's click restart and see if it works. It may not work. We may have to reboot. If we do, I'll pause the video again. So now it says it can't update the config, so we'll do a firmware restart. And if this doesn't work, I need to reboot. So it looks like it did work. So to test that it's actually working correctly, you can see the thermistors over here for both. I'm gonna put one between my thumb and my forefinger. So I'll go back over to the desk. I'll grab one of these, I'll put my fingers around it, and then we'll go back over to the desktop. So as you can see, the temperature is starting to rise in here for the actual thermistor that I have between my thumb and my index finger. So if you like the tutorial, please remember to like and subscribe so that you can see more content on this. And also I need to thank BigTreeTech for providing me with the board and the CB1 module for the Raspberry Pi alternative, and also my patrons and the people that tip me on PayPal. All those links should be in the description if you choose to do it yourself. And I will place a thank you note at the end of the video. So everyone take care, be safe, and I'll see you later.